to second chapter of class 8, velocity and accelerations. Previous class you have studied about the measurement. Today you will discuss about the velocity and accelerations. Okay, let's talk about the velocity and accelerations. First of all, to go from the velocity, we have to understand some of the terms. Okay, so I have written here from the reference point. Okay, where is it? Reference point. What is that reference point? Okay, the point about which we study the motion of an object, that is called what? Reference point. It means from where the body starts. Yes, from where the body starts, that point is called what? Reference point. Suppose, take one example I am showing you. Suppose this is the car. Okay, this is car, and this car starts from here. Okay, this is the reference point. The car starts from point A, and this point A is the reference point. So the point about which we study the motion of an object, that is called what? Reference point. Okay, so we have to note it. What is the reference point? What is that reference point? From where the body starts, that point is said to be the what? Reference point. For that, now when we talk about the reference point, now let's take concept about the rest and motion. What is that rest and motion? Before going to the velocity, we have to take more concept about the rest and motion. Rest means, as you know, when we look our surrounding, yes, in our locality, you will see the various things. Yes or no? Some of things are in the rest position, where some of them are in the what? In motion positions. It means those bodies which are in do not change its position with respect to a reference point as they taken their surroundings. That is called what? Rest. Rest means, like as we have seen the building, tower, houses. So rest, it means the body which do not, the body is said to be the rest if the body does not change its position with respect to their fixed point taken as the reference point on its surrounding. It means, like if you take the example tower, yes, the tower changes its position, now it is in rest position. It means this, the positions which do not change according to the surrounding, we have seen that types of the body is said to be the what? Rest. So for that, the reference point is, have you seen here the reference point? Reference point means the points where we have to take the fixed, that is the from where we have to compare, that is also the what? Reference point. So you can easily take the concept of the rest. What is that rest? Rest means those body which does not change its position with respect to the surroundings, that is said to be the what? Rest. Like as what? Electric pole, houses, buildings, these all are the what? Concepts about the rest. So now we will talk about the motions. What is this? Motions. We will talk about the motion. What is that? Motion. Motion means our body is said to be the motions if the body does not change its position with, if the position change, the body will change its position with respect to taking the reference point on its surrounding, that is said to be the word motion. Motion means the movement. The reference point which whatever you have taken in your surrounding, from that reference point, if the body is in motion, okay, then they are said to be what? In motion. Suppose here is the flying bird. Yes, the flying body is in motion. Running bus or man running on a road. It means they are in the motion with the respect to their reference point which is taken to from our surrounding. Means when we compare with our surroundings, these body are in what? In motion. In motion. So they are called what? Motions. So our body is said to be the motions if the body changes its position with respect to a fixed point taken as the reference point on its surrounding. So surrounding is our what? Reference point. So they are what? In motions. So in this way, the rest and the motions are also called as the relative terms. What is the, how we can say that rest and motions are the relative terms? So now let's talk about what is the rest and the motions. This rest and motion, how is the rest and motion are relative term? This is a very VI questions for you, the examination point of view. How does rest and motions are relative terms? So let us consider that we are sitting among a bus. We are in the motions with respect to the trees or the buildings outside of the bus, because our position is changing with the respect to them. However, if we compare our positions with the respect to the things inside the bus with the other passenger seats, they are in the rest. Thus, the objects can be the rest in the relation to the other objects, while it can be in the motions in the relation of the other object at the same instant of the time. Therefore, we can say that rest and motion are the relative terms. It means what? Suppose, take one example. Suppose this is a bus, okay? What is this? It is a bus. Bus. Okay. Bus. Okay. Means here are the, some of the passengers are inside the bus. There are some of the passengers. And there are some of the trees. Some of the trees. Okay, buildings. Buildings. Now, look at the pictures. We are considering the passengers. Suppose inside the bus, when we compare these passengers are in motion with respect to their surrounding, because they are in the motion, because this tree, building, tower does not change its position, but the passengers are changing at the time. So the instincts of their surrounding, what are they? The passengers are in motion. But inside this bus, when we talk this inside in this bus, they are in the number seat number 1, seat number 2, seat number 3, seat number 4. Means they are in the rest. They are not changing its position. We have seen there in the picture. They do not change the position. It means they are in rest with each other, but all of them are in motion with their respect to their surrounding. In this way, we can consider that rest and motions are what? Both are the relative terms. Once again, this is the bus. Inside the bus, there are some of the passengers. When these passengers are in the rest position with the respect to each other inside the bus. Because these passengers do not change its position, they are in the constant position. They do not. It means that they are in the what? In the rest position inside the bus. But these passengers are also in the motions when they look from the surrounding. Because this bus are saying these passengers are in the motions. Because when they look the trees, yes, they go to behind it. They are in the motions with respect to the surrounding. So in this way, you can consider that rest and motions are the relative terms, and these questions are very, very important. You can also take write in your copy. It's a very important questions for your exam point of the point. Please pause the video and write all this clearly. There is a written. Okay, you can easily write in your notebook. Okay. Okay, now let's talk about uniform motion and non-uniform motion. I have already told you what are the motions. Body will change the positions with respect to their surrounding, that is what? Motion. But now, here is the uniform motion and non-uniform motions. So let's talk first of all about the uniform motions. What is that uniform motions? When the body covers an equal distance in equal interval of time, that is called what? Uniform motion. Just I will show you here. Only look at the examples. Suppose here is one car. This is a car. C A R car. Okay, this is the car. This car covers the equal distance in equal interval of time. That is called what? Uniform motion. Yes. Here, suppose it is a 2 meter distance. 2 meter distance. 2 meter distance. 2 meter. 2 meter. 2 meter. It covers in 1 second. 1 second. 1 second. 1 second. 1 second. 1 second. In 1 second. It means when your body covers an equal distance in equal interval of time. We have looked at the pictures here. The body are covering equal distance. The distance between point A to B is 2 meter. B to C is 2 meter. C to D is 2 meter. To E, F, and G. It means they covers what? Equal time. 1 second. 1 second. 1 second. But these types of the motions, when the body are in the motions, they are said to be uniform motion. Here is the example I am showing you. Car. This car covers the equal distance, 2 meter in 1 second, 1 second, 2 meter in 1 second, 2 meter in 1 second, means this type of motions are called what? Uniform motions. Okay, once again, this is when our body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, they are called what? Uniform motion. Okay, here a couple are covering the 2 meter distance in 1 second. Okay, 2 meter distance in 1 second. It means this car covers the what? Equal distance. Equal distance covering. A to B is 2 meter. B to C is 2 meter. These types of motions are said to be what? Uniform motions. So now, non-uniform motion. What is that? Non-uniform motion. Now, non-uniform. What is this non-uniform motion? When a body does not cover the equal distance in equal interval of time, that is called what? Non-uniform motion. It means the body which are in motions, they does not cover the equal distance in equal interval of time. Now, look all of you here. Here is the car. Yes, this car covers in 1 second 2 meter. 1 second from B to C, in one second 5 meter. C to D in 1 second, 3 meters, 1 second in 6 meter, 1 second in 2 meter, 1 second in. It means that this car is covering the equal distance. Yes or no? Covering? Not covering. Okay. This car is not covering the equal distance. Yes? So, this type of the motion of the body is said to be what? Non-uniform motion. What is that non-uniform motion? The way of a body does not covers equal distance in equal interval of time, they are called what? Non-uniform motions. Once again, look this picture carefully. Take a concept. What is that? How it is non-uniform motion? Car. Yes, we have seen their car. This car covers in 1 second 2 meter. 1 second, 1 second 5 meter. In 1 second 3 meter. In 1 second 6 meter. In 1 second, 2 meter, in 1 second, 4 meter. It means this car does not cover the equal distance. Yes, in equal interval of time. So these types of the body, this type of the motion of the body is said to be what? Non-uniform motion. Okay. Okay, next let's discuss about the speed. What is that speed? The rate of change of distance is called what? Speed. Means the rate of change of distance, that is called what? Speed. Or we can also define as, it can be defined as the distance traveled by a body in a unit time in any distance or in any direction, that is called what? Speed. Means we are using the different types of the vehicles, like as a motorcycle, you are, yes, car, bus, yes, at the time. We have seen in their speed. What is inside that speed? That motorcycle or in the bus, there is a speedometer which indicates the speed of that vehicle. What is that speedometer? S-P-E-E-D-O-M-E-T-E-R. Speedometer. This speedometer helps to indicate the what is the speed of your vehicles while you are using the motorbike. What is the speed of that vehicle? We can see where in the speedometer. This speedometer helps to indicate the speed of the vehicles. Now, means the rate of change in the distance, that is called what? The speed. We can calculate the speed by using the formula distance traveled by the time taken. What is distance traveled by the time taken? Defined as the distance traveled by a body in a unit time. That is also called what? Speed. So S is equal to d by t. Speed can be measured in meter per second. Meter per second. Just I will show you here. S is equal to d by t. D means distance, that is the meter, and t means time, that is the second. So it is called what? Meter per second. So the unit of the speed is what? Meter per second. Now average speed. What is average speed? The average speed is defined as the ratio of total distance traveled to a total time taken. That is called what? Average speed. What is average speed? The average speed is defined as the ratio of total distance traveled to the total time taken. Just I will show you. Look at the board here. Means in your daily life, you are using different types of the vehicles. Yes. Suppose you are riding a bike. Yes. And in 1 second you have covered 2 meters. Okay. In 2 seconds you have covered 4 meters. Yes. In 3 seconds you have covered 10 meters. The distance. Yes. So what is the average speed? You have to calculate here by the average speed is equal to the total distance. The total distance means what? 2 meter plus 4 meter plus 10 meter by what is the time taken by a body? 1 second plus 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is called what? Second. It means what is 10 to 14, 14 to 16 by how much? 3 to 5 to 6 meter per second. So we can also write here, it means we have to divide it. Here 2.8 meter per second. It means that the average speed of that bike is what? 2.8 meter per second. In this way, we can calculate out the average speed. Average speed means the total distance traveled by the total time taken. Total distance. Just I have told you, in 1 second a body covers 1 meter, 2 seconds a body covers 4 meter, in 3 seconds a body covers 10 meter. Yes or no? So the total distance traveled by a body and the total time taken. When you divide it by the total time taken, that is what? Average speed. Okay, you get in this way you can calculate the easily what is the speed of the vehicles and the average speed too. Okay. Yes, friends, we have studied about speed, direction, motions, uniform and non-uniform motions. Okay, now we have to do some homeworks related to the chapters. Define the rest and motion with example. Write any two differences between uniform motion and non-uniform motion. What is speed? Write down the formula to calculate the average speed. Which instrument is used to find the speed of vehicles? And one numerical question. A boy runs 10 meters in 2 seconds. What is the speed? So you have to do this as your homeworks in your note copy. This is you can send me in this your ID from my ID also. I can check your homeworks there. So you can do this and send me in your ID. Okay, thank you.